गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, आई होप यू ऑल आर वेल एट होम एंड ऑल्सो योर फैमिली इज डूइंग ग्रेट. ओके चिल्ड्रन, नाउ एज वी नो दैट वी हैव कम्प्लीटेड द होल सिलेबस ऑफ द SST. होल मीन्स ओनली द सिलेबस विच इज रिलेटेड टू PT1, है ना, पीरियोडिक टेस्ट 1 दैट वी हैव कम्प्लीटेड. सो चिल्ड्रन, टूडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू अवर SST पीरियड विद द क्विज. सो हियर चिल्ड्रन, I am going to ask you some questions like fill in the blanks, true or false, choose the correct option. Okay? So like that question I will ask you. And then you have to give the answer for it. Okay children? And you will write these questions and answers in the rough notebook or which is extra notebook if you have, you will write there this for the practice. Okay? Yes children. So shall we start? Yes, children, so the first one question is fill in the blanks, right? So what is the first one? On 24th of January 1950, Dash was adopted as our national anthem. See the one more time. On 24th of January 1950, Dash was adopted as our national anthem. What will be the answer, children? Which song was adopted as a national anthem on 24th of January 1950? Yes, it's very simple. What is the answer? Jana Gana Mana. Right? So here we will write Jana Gana Mana. See here. Jana Gana Mana. Children, you have to write with the pencil with neat and clean handwriting. Okay? Yes. So, next is the dash color in Tiranga symbolizes courage and sacrifice. Which is the color, children, which symbolizes in our national flag that courage and sacrifice? Now you know, na, our national flags has 3 colors, right? Orange, white and then green. So each color symbolizes something. Now from among that 3 colors, one color is there which symbolizes courage and sacrifice. So what is that color in our national flag? Who will tell me? It is saffron, that is orange color, hai na? So we'll write down here saffron, SAFFRON, right? Saffron. Third number, the Buddhist stupas are located in dash and dash. So where is the located, where, what is the location of the Buddhist stupa? Where does it located? The Buddhist stupas are located in dash and dash. What will be the answer, children? Just think. The Buddhist stupas are located in Sanchi and Sarnath. So here we'll write down Sanchi. S-A-N-C-H-I. Sanchi and Sarnath. S-A-R-N-A-T-H. Finished? Completed? Yes. Next is dash are also called as Sahyadri. Dash are also called as Sahyadri. So what is the thing that we also called it as a Sahyadri? What is that? Just think. It is Western Ghat. What it is? Western Ghat. So, the Western Ghats are also called as Sahyadri. So, what we will write here? Western Ghat. WESTERN Western GHATS Ghats are also called as Sahyadri. And last, Thangta is the tribal dance of the state of Dash. Thangta is the tribal dance of the state of Dash. So which state having Thangta tribal dance? What it is? What is the name of the state? Thangta is the tribal dance of the state of Manipur. So what will be the answer? It is Manipur. MANIPUR. It is Manipur. So till here everyone finished? Everyone completed? Children, you have to write these question and answers in the notebook. Got it? Yes. So shall I erase? Shall I rub this? The next question is, state true or false? Now the first one, Fulkari and chicken curry are types of embroidery done in India. Is it true or false, children? Is this sentence is correct or wrong? Fulkari and chicken curry are types of embroidery done in India. Is it true or false? It is true. So we will write here T. Next, the Constitution of India recognizes 22 languages. The Constitution of India recognizes 22 languages. Is it right or wrong, children? It is true. It is right. So we'll write here T. Next, there are 26 spokes in the Ashok Chakra. Now, do you know, children, Indian national flag? Right? So, in that, three colors are there. And three horizontal bands are there. That is orange, white and green. And exact at the center of the flag on the white band, there is Ashok Chakra. You know this thing. And in that Ashok Chakra, there are 26 spokes in the Ashok Chakra. So, is it right or wrong? How many spokes are there in the Ashok Chakra, children? Who will tell me? It is in the first lesson. You know this thing, hai na? There are 26 spokes in the Ashok Chakra. So total how many spokes are there? There are 24 spokes in the Ashok Chakra. How many? 24. So this sentence is false. So we'll write here F. Fourth, the capital city of Telangana and Andhra Pradesh is Hyderabad. Now see, the capital city of Telangana and Andhra Pradesh is Hyderabad. Is it right or wrong, children? it is right, it means it is true. So we have to write here T. And last, Lakshadweep Islands lie in the Bay of Bengal. Lakshadweep Islands lie in the Bay of Bengal. Is it true or false? Just think. Children, it is false. Lakshadweep Islands lie in the Bay of Bengal. This sentence is false. So what will be the correct sentence? The correct sentence is Lakshadweep Islands lie in the Arabian Sea. Where it is? In the Arabian Sea. So this sentence is false. So we have to write F over there. Okay? Have you understood, children? Shall I rub this? Yes. Then next is match the following. Two columns are here. Punjab National Tree, Brihadeshwara Temple, Kathakali, Union Territory. And here Tamil Nadu, Daman and Diu, Kerala, Banyan, Gidda. So we have to match the following. Now children, here the first one is Punjab. Now what will be the correct pair for the Punjab? What is there in the next column? Gidda. Gidda means it is the folk dance of Punjab. It is the traditional dance of Punjab. So we will match this to E. So here we will write down answer E. Second one, national tree. Okay. Children, so what is the national tree? It's banyan tree. So we'll write down here D. The national tree of India is banyan tree. So we wrote D over there. Third number, Brihadeshwara Temple. So what will be the answer for the Brihadeshwara Temple? Brihadeshwara Temple comes in the state of Tamil Nadu. So we'll write here A. Next, Kathakali. Kathakali is the traditional dance of or folk dance of C, Kerala. And last, Union Territory. What is the Union Territory from this next column? It's Daman and Diu. So we'll write down B. Yes, children. So have you understood? Match the following. Okay. Everyone completed till here? Yes, if you want to write, if you are taking much time, then please you will pause the video and complete the writing first and then we will continue with the video. Okay? So shall I erase this? Now, the next question is, choose the correct option. What is the next question? It is, choose the correct option. Now here children, the first one is, the tallest mountain peak in the world. What is the tallest mountain peak in the world? And the options are K2, Kanchenjunga, Everest, Nilgiris. Just think, children, which is the tallest mountain peak in the world? इट्स K2, कांचनजंगा, एवरेस्ट और नीलगिरीज. चिल्ड्रन, इन द वर्ल्ड इज एस्ट, नॉट इन द कंट्री, नॉट इन इंडिया, इन द वर्ल्ड. सो वट विल बी द आंसर? इट इज ऑप्शन सी, एवरेस्ट. सो वी हैव टू टेक इट. सेकेंड नंबर, द रिवर सतलज एंटर्स इंडिया थ्रू दिस पास. द रिवर सतलज एंटर्स इन इंडिया थ्रू दिस पास एंड द ऑप्शंस आर रोहतांग पास, शिपकिला पास, नथुला पास एंड ऑल ऑफ दिस. सो विच वन इज द करेक्ट आंसर? द रिवर सतलज एंटर्स इंडिया थ्रू दिस पास. वॉट इज द करेक्ट आंसर? It is option B, that is Shipkila Pass. Third number is, the Great Indian Desert lies in this Indian state. The Great Indian Desert lies in this Indian state. And the options are Uttar Pradesh, Rajasthan, Haryana, Punjab. What is the correct answer for it? The Great Indian Desert lies in which state? Which Indian state? Uttar Pradesh, Rajasthan, Haryana, Punjab. What is the correct answer? Desert children, complete dry place, sandy region. Scarcity of water. So where does it all? Yes children, it is option B, Rajasthan. So we'll tick it. Yes, option B, Rajasthan. Rajasthan is very famous for the desert. Last, the Aravallis, Vindhyas, Chota Nagpur Plateau and Rajmahal Hills border this region of Southern Plateau. See one more time. The Aravallis, Vindhyas, Chota Nagpur Plateau and Rajmahal Hills border this region of Southern Plateau. Central Highlands, Deccan Plateau, River Narmada or Western Ghat. Which is the correct answer? You can read it one more time. The Aravallis, Vindhyas, Chota Nagpur Plateau and Rajmahal Hills border this region of Southern Plateau. And the options are Central Highlands, Deccan Plateau, River Narmada, Western Ghats. So the correct answer is what? The correct answer is Central Highlands. So we'll tick to option A. Okay. Children, while writing in the notebook, no need to write all the options. Only you will write down the question below that one dash and whatever the correct answer is there, that only you will write. No need to write all the options. Okay. So shall I erase? Shall I rub this? Now here, once again, true or false? Yes, children. Now here, some sentences are given that we have to identify whether these sentences are true or false. Now here children, total 5 questions are given. And these are the sentences from the lesson number 4, 5 and 6. Right? So children, for the PT 1, only lesson number 4 and 5. What is the portion for the PT1? Lesson number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and directly lesson number 16. So lesson number 6 is not for the PT1 test. So here one sentence is from lesson number 6 that we are not going to solve. Okay? So I will erase this first. This is not for the syllabus, for the PT1 test. Second number, alluvium supports the cultivation of rice in the eastern coastal plains. Alluvium supports the cultivation of rice in the eastern coastal plains. True or false? What is the answer? It is true. So we'll write here T. Children, I think so this sentence is also from the lesson number 6. Because we have learnt the northern plains and this sentence is related to the eastern coastal plains. But still I wrote the answers, but it is not for the PT1 test. Okay. Third number, the Chota Nagpur Plateau region is rich in mineral deposits. I will cut this. It is not for the PT1. Third number, Chota Nagpur Plateau region is rich in mineral deposits. True or false? Yes, children, the Chota Nagpur Plateau is very famous for the mineral deposit. So it is true. We'll write T. Fourth, the western coastal plains are divided into 3 parts. It is also from the lesson number 6, which is not for the PT1 test. Fifth, the Deccan Plateau is the largest plateau in India. The Deccan Plateau is the largest plateau in India. Is it right or wrong? It is true. Deccan Plateau is largest plateau in India. So we'll write T. Okay, children? Yes. Have you wrote? Shall I erase this? Yes. Now here what we have to do is underline the correct answer. Means choose the correct option. Yes. So what is the first one sentence? First one question, that is river originating in Central Highlands. River originating in Central Highlands. And the options are Chambal, Yamuna, Satluj. What is the correct answer? Just think, which river originates in Central Highlands? And the options are Chambal, Yamuna and Satluj. What is the correct option? Yes, children. River originating in Central Highlands. What is the correct answer? And the correct answer is Chambal. What is it? It's Chambal. So, we'll underline the word Chambal. It is the correct answer. Now, question number 2 and question number 3 are both the questions from the lesson number 6, which are not for the PT1 test. So, I am going to erase this. Number 4, the seasonal river of
the Great Indian Desert is Luni, Shon or Godavari? Do you know the that thing ki in the Great Indian Desert there is a Indira Gandhi Canal for the supply of the water which is made by the government, right? So in that Great Indian Desert, which is the seasonal river, Luni, Shon or Godavari? And the correct answer is Luni. So we are going to underline the Luni. Okay, last, fifth number. Lower Himalayas are also known by this name. Now you know there are three parallel ranges of the Himalayan mountains, isn't it? So what is the another name for the lower Himalayas? And the options are Himachal, Shivalik and Himadri. Which is the correct answer? Lower Himalayas are also known by this name, Himachal, Shivalik and Himadri. So what is the another name for the lower Himalayas? Yes, children. And the correct answer is Shivalik. So we will underline it. Okay? Have you understood? Shall I erase this? Yes. Now children, here are some fill in the blanks for the revision as a part of a quiz. So we are going to solve it. Yes. So the first one, Qutbuddin Aibak was the founder of the Dash, which is related to the lesson number 16, Passage of Time. So Qutbuddin Aibak was the founder of the Dash. What will be the answer, children? Just think. Yes, so Qutbuddin Aibak was the founder of the Delhi Sultanate. So we'll write down the answer. D-E-L-H-I, Delhi, S-U-L, T-A-N-A-T, na? Delhi, Sultanate, T-A-N-A-T-E is there. Second, Dash was the important ruler of the Mughal dynasty. So who was the important ruler of the Mughal dynasty, children? Dash was the important ruler of the Mughal dynasty. Just think. Children, do you know who is the founder or what we can say, foundation, who did the foundation for the Mughal dynasty in India? So the first one is Babur. After Babur, his son Humayun. After Humayun, Humayun's son Akbar. After Akbar, his son Jahangir. After Jahangir, Jahangir's son Shahjahan. And after Shahjahan, Aurangzeb was the successor of the Mughal dynasty. Now, Aurangzeb is the last emperor. So, who was the important ruler? So the answer is Aurangzeb. So we'll write here A U R A N G Z E B. Now, Dash attacked India in 326 BCE. So who attacked India in 326 CE? Find out the answer. Dash attacked India in 326 CE. And the answer is Alexander. So here I am going to write A L E X A N D E R. So Alexander attacked India in 326 CE. Next, the Dash civilization is the oldest civilization of India. Which is the oldest civilization of India, children? Just think. Very simple it is. The Dash civilization is the oldest civilization of India. Indus Valley. So we'll write down the Indus. I-N-D-U-S V-A-L-L-E-Y. Indus Valley civilization is the oldest civilization of India. Next. The civilization had well-planned cities and building like the Dash in Mohenjo-daro and the Dash in Harappa. Now children, the cities are very well-planned and constructed very well. So, what is the famous construction from the city of Mohenjo-daro and from the city of Harappa? The Dash in Mohenjo-daro. So what is famous from Mohenjo-daro? The Great Bath. G-R-E-A-T. Great. B-A-T-H. And the Dash in Harappa. Granary. Granary means where we can store the grains. G R A N A R Y. And last, after Chandragupta Maurya, Dash became the emperor. So after Chandragupta Maurya, who became the emperor? After Chandragupta Maurya, who became the emperor? I will give you one clue. After Chandragupta Maurya, his grandson became the emperor. Now tell me, what is the name of the grandson of Chandragupta Maurya? After Chandragupta Maurya, Ashoka, the grandson, he became the emperor. So we'll write A S H O K A. Ashoka became the emperor. Yes, children. So, have you understood? Children, in this way, we have revised all the topics with the help of quiz. In this quiz, the questions are related to the all the topics which are there for the PT1. So, you will write down these all questions in the notebook. You will practice it. Okay. So, it will be easy for your study of the PT1 test. I hope, children, you will write these all in neat and clean handwriting without making any spelling mistake. Have you understood? Very good. Now, children, if you have any doubt, any queries, you can feel free to ask me My email ID is ibbct@prathibaintschool.org. Okay? Yes, sir. So till then, take care of yourself, stay home, stay safe. Bye-bye. Have a nice day.